you clone freak!
Don't you use that tone with me.
Welcome back, and thank you for tuning into Thembo Cinema, where we love all things TV, film, and especially horror. But today, we are time-traveling back to 2003, where Walt Disney Pictures released the Freaky Friday remake. And who better to re-examine this film than one of my childhood besties? They are an actor, producer, supermodel of the world, and they kept me sane in my little gay brain in 2003. It is Danni, Vitorino! Hey. Thank you for joining us, Danni.
Thanks for having me. It's been so long.
Yes. Honestly, we were little queens. We saw each other.
Yeah. We would run around the living room and just, like, watch movies and have sleepovers and just, like, be weird. It was amazing.
Right. I think it's so amazing what you've done with your career. Just all the projects you've been involved in. It's been amazing to see you grow just, like, from the sidelines. And I'm always rooting for you.
Thank you. That means the world to me because it's very isolating in this industry sometimes. And, yeah, it's not an easy road.
Okay, so let's get into Freaky Friday. Like,
Anna, honey, wake up.
Oh, I have had it.
What? I'm ready.
For the Coleman family, Mondays are manic.
Hi, honey. Make good choices.
Wednesdays are wild. And for Anna and Tess, there's never enough time to really understand each other.
What? Time's up. It's after six.
But on Friday...
You think my life is perfect?
You couldn't last one day in my high school.
Cookie.
That's all about to change. Because things are going to get a little freaky.
Why am I in Anna's room?
This isn't mine. Those aren't mine. That's definitely not mine.
Walt Disney Pictures presents...
So, you're in my body and I'm in your body.
I'm old!
I beg your pardon.
Oh, I'm like the Crypt Keeper!
Freaky Friday.
Why don't we, like...
Yes, a jolt! Go!
Coming soon to Disney DVD and video.
I don't know if you know this. This movie is a remake of the 1976 Jodie Foster classic Freaky Friday. Have you ever seen that movie?
No, and I didn't know Jodie Foster was in that. Oh my gosh.
Yes, it was during like those Disney classic eras with like the Love Bug and stuff like that, where they went for like a zany comedy kind of. It was more of like switching them to get them to do like hijinks or whatever. Like that one's kind of a classic to me too. The 2003 one is definitely such a much-needed update and makes it so much more modern and just, like, more about, like, what, like, maybe women actually go through. Now, when do you remember first seeing this one? Did you see it in theaters?
No, I didn't see it in theaters. I think I saw it on DVD. Or maybe, like, on the Disney Channel if they played it. Right? Like, they would do that.
Get ready for a Freaky Friday. Friday at 9, 8 Central on Disney Channel.
Disney Channel also did remake it one more time a couple years ago, and I was like, why did they do that? But apparently it's like the musical version, and I watched like a scene from it where they switch, and I was like, okay, I'm done. Yeah. It's like, if you like the musical, it's probably cute.
Wait, what? They remade it? You know, they did the same thing with Under Wraps. Do you remember Under Wraps, the Halloween?
Oh my god, I'm
they
so
remade
pissed.
It and
I'm
said
so
no one.
Pissed.
Yeah, they didn't tell anybody.
So in 2003, we were all just, you know, sitting there minding our own business, and then wham, we were in the middle of a Lindsay Lohan essence in the 2000s.
Hi, I'm Lindsay Lohan from Freaky Friday.
Yes.
Of course, we all fell in love with Lindsay Lohan in 1998 and The Parent Trap, where I think a lot of us thought those were two different girls, and then we were like, our minds were blown when we found out it was just this one very talented actress, Lindsay Lohan. She also went on to do movies like Life Size in the year 2000. There was one movie called like Get a Clue, which I don't think I saw that one, but it was on Disney Channel like all the time. This was kind of her introduction to us anew as a teenager, a little bit more grown up. And I think all of us kind of wanted to see like if she's going to bring that Parent Trap magic back. And I feel like she brings a lot of those acting chops back into this film as well.
100%.
Now, were you a fan of the Lilo?
Yes, especially after this movie. I watched this movie and I was like, oh my god, yeah. Like, you know when you watch a movie and then that's your personality and like, I don't know. I was Freaky Friday with her. Like, I was like, okay, I'm Lindsay Lohan. Like,
you're like, oh, that's me. Like, right. I got it.
I bought her album.
I love Rumors. Rumors is iconic.
Rumors was, I listened to Rumors and I walked down that sixth grade hallway like no one's business.
We were living.
Because right after 2003, Freaky Friday was Mean Girls, 2004.
Right. Also, the director of Freaky Friday is Mark Waters, who also went on to direct Lindsay Lohan in Mean Girls the next year.
Yes. She's the one Disney child actor, I would say, that really was able to, like, get out of that mold, but in a good way, you know, because people do trap them in their minds, like, in this industry, when you're formed as this Disney gem. Mm-hmm. Because then, you know, it's very Disney, it's very pure, it's very funny, it's very witty, it's very, like, whatever that is. And so if you want to go into, like, a different movie franchise, they're going to be like, well, wait, we only see you as this, you know what I mean?
Totally. And, like, she kind of, like, led that way for people like Miley, other people who kind of broke that Disney mode by kind of showing a more adult side or being, like, you know, showing just, like, different type of other chops, basically. Yeah. And I feel like we've all, like, especially throughout the late 2000s, we all really experienced the roller coaster of headlines and stuff that happened to Lindsay Lohan. And, you know, it was fun, scary sometimes, sad sometimes. But I really enjoy, like, where she's at in life now. She just had a baby and she seems to be, like, doing it. And she seems to be, like, in a really stable, like, healthy place. So good for her. Good for the Lilo.
Good for Lindsay.
You need to cut the... You really do. Okay. Just cut the... Okay.
Now, of course, the other star of this movie. Really, this movie is made by the chemistry with these two actresses. So, Jamie Lee Curtis is Hollywood royalty. Her mother is Psycho's Janet Leigh, and her dad is Tony Curtis. And she is a scream queen herself, starring in the iconic horror franchise Halloween as Laurie Strode.
You can't kill the boogeyman.
Come on, Tommy. And after being a scream queen throughout the 80s, she became a bona fide actress with movies like True Lies and A Fish Called Wanda and solidified herself as a Hollywood heavy hitter.
I watched Halloween for the first time like last year.
Oh, okay.
I have never really watched that film because scary movies just aren't really my thing. Jamie Lee Curtis is one of those actresses, one of those artists, one of those performers that she steps on that stage, she says, what do you want? And she does it. She heard stay, and then she slayed, or like whatever it is.
Yeah,
like whatever. Heard it, like everything she does.
Yeah, she has like the ultimate cool aunt energy. Like she's that bitch.
Yes, and you know, there's a video of her online on YouTube talking about her film career. And she was talking about Freaky Friday, and she was like, this film, like, they just last minute cast me.
This movie is going to Disney, and they have asked if you will be in it. It was a Thursday. They sent me the script. I read it on the plane. I met the director on Saturday. I had my hair dyed red on Sunday, and I was shooting on Monday. So the beauty of that movie is that I just jumped into it with absolutely zero prep on any level.
So like watching the film, you're like, holy shit, like she's really just like having fun and like...
Yeah, you know, it feels like it's a lot of herself. Like she's bringing a lot of Jamie Lee to it. You have Jamie Lee Curtis playing Tess, the mother who's like a therapist.
Hello, Dr. Coleman. Yes, Elizabeth. Yes, Elizabeth, I'll be at the appointment tomorrow. And Elizabeth, remember, you are a smart, strong, beautiful, independent woman, and you don't need a man to complete you. Thank you. Goodbye.
So like, funny.
I need that sequel where it's just her and she's like,
I'm just delicate. She went out and bought her book Through the Looking Glass, Senescence in Retrograde.
And that's also a great drag name.
Senescence. Please welcome to the stage, Senescence.
Senescence in Retrograde.
And you have Lindsay Lohan playing Anna, who is like her teenage daughter, who is like in a band with her friends and feels misunderstood by her mom. Parents just don't understand. Cue, what's that freaking Simple Plan song? Yeah. Main reason why this movie works so well is because of Act One. If they didn't set up these characters for who they are in the beginning so well, like, the movie would not work and the switch wouldn't work.
Yes, and this film does a great job. I don't know if it's the direction, the actors, the cinematography, or like everything. It's probably just a combo of like a great cast and crew. Each character, whether they're principal or secondary or whatever featured, like the grandpa, like he has his staple where he like does like the earthquake thing.
Mm-hmm.
The little brother has a moment.
At the beginning of the movie, you don't really know why there's such tension.
Yeah.
You don't know, like, you're just like, oh, it's just a teenager and her mom, so they're fighting or whatever.
Right.
And you'd know that if you paid, like, a speck of attention.
Anna?
What?
I think you know I pay attention, Anna. Enough to know that you got an F in English today?
It's until, like, later in the movie that you realize, like, oh, no, like, their dad had died just 3 years before this. So yeah. She's, like, adjusting, you know?
And that's what makes this movie so watchable, because you start off, like you said, with the, like, obvious, which is, like, okay, a mom and a teenage girl, they're gonna fight, and then they switch bodies, and it's like, oh, we find out there are layers. There are layers.
Like onions.
You get it. We both have layers.
Let's, like, discuss how they do the switch, because, like, this was fun at the time, but this aged horribly.
Cookie.
Strange Asian voodoo brought up multiple times, which is just, it's so not okay, guys. This, it's a fortune cookie. Fortune cookies, everybody. That's what we're doing here in 2003.
Yeah.
Which is unfortunate, because I actually really do love the actresses that play the mother and daughter in the restaurant. They're really, like, they're really good actresses and they're funny. They're just, like, giving the lowest common denominator comedy that they can give them for their scenes.
100%. He did a great job at playing the caricature, and it sucks that they had to do that, but they did a great job doing it in a way that's still tasteful and funny and not too crazy, you know what I mean? And
yeah.
You find the answer in each other. When the fortune come true, then you go back, okay? No big deal.
It's insane watching it. I was like, someone's making them do this. You know what I mean? Like, it's very.
Yeah, I do love seeing them. And it's like, it's just a completely wrong setup. It's just not a way to do it. Let's go from, like, one problematic part of the movie to the other one, which is Chad Michael Murray as Jake.
Yes.
And he's not even looking.
He's not? He's not looking. He's totally looking.
So, like, little preteen me did not see this as a problematic relationship at all in this movie. I thought it was, like, purely fun, you know? I think this is actually my introduction to Chad Michael Murray. He plays Jake, this guy at the high school, who, like, age is very, like, ambiguous. Is he 18? Is he 16? I mean, he seems to be interested in Anna, but, like, is kind of, like, you know, softly approaching her, and she's very awkward, and it's very cute, you know, innocent. And then the switch happens. Now it's Jamie Lee Curtis, Anna, and Jamie Lee and Tessa's body, like, you know, flirting with him and being all weird. And he starts to, like, fall in love with the mother.
Hi. It's a great bike.
What? Not like I've ever been on it. I'm not allowed.
And, like, it really is played for, like, such broad comedy. Like, the movie is not trying to be weird about it. I just think it's... Wow, Disney in 2003 was doing this.
Hit me, baby, one more time.
It's kind of crazy.
I think it was done very tastefully, and it was done in a way where it wasn't, like, creepy or cringe. And, I mean, the actors as well. Like, the actors made it very well done on them, because it could have gone in a different way.
he seemed to like follow the personality wherever the personality of Anna's personality went.
Yes.
Which is kind of a good thing, maybe.
I think he just falls in love because when they switch bodies, I feel like they really let loose a bit more with their personalities. Yeah. I think when he sees that, he just falls like head over first.
And then weirdly enough, at the end, when he sees Lindsay Lohan like miming, playing the guitar at the end, he's like, oh wait, no, I'm into her. Okay, I was confused.
I want something
It's just very funny. And the whole hit me baby one more time of it is like kind of iconic.
I forgot about that and I watched it. I forgot about a lot of this movie and I watched it and I was like, this movie's really good. It's really good staple moments that like solidify the relationships and everything. Mm-hmm.
Do you have any specific scenes that are just like your favorite?
Lindsay Lohan tackling Chad Michael outside of the house while he's singing Hit Me Baby One More Time.
Hit me baby!
It's great. I love the guitar moment at the end.
The
audition when Jamie Lee is just like...
And that's such a good part of like the climax of the emotional arc of the movie too. I just think she did kind of think her daughter's music was like kind of dumb.
Yeah.
She never said that, but it seemed like it. I think she was like, oh my god, I have like a whole new respect for this bitch.
I had no idea what it takes. I mean, the guts.
Yeah.
Mutual respect was just beautiful. And especially, I love the scene after that when they end up back at the wedding rehearsal. And they just, when they give those speeches, I think that the two actresses really do their greatest work where the full like picture of the movie comes together where like you do learn like when the dad died and like you really get to the pinpoint of like why there even was tension to begin with and how they're confronting it in that moment. And it's just like beautiful, gorgeous. I was crying. Beautiful. And you have the ultimate wrap up of the movie at the end with the wedding where you have Anna's band Pink Slip. When music in this movie is so underrated, like the band is actually like a really good band with an original song, and she gets to play at the wedding, which shows like the ultimate like retribution and understanding between mother and daughter, and it's gorgeous.
Yeah, honestly, that band was so good. Those songs, like I thought it was an actual band, but it was a fake band.
Right? Like I will never be that cool.
No, Lindsay Lohan actually got those blonde streaks. Actually, in her hair. She did it right before the film started, and she was
Kelly
like,
Clarkson in Streaks from Hell.
Yes. And it actually worked really, like,
it yeah. Really, it, I mean, to me, like, that is, like, that's important for that character.
Really played into this, like, rocker, edgy character.
2003, like, all of that fashion is, like, kind of back, which I love. Like,
it's yeah. Yeah.
What a time.
What a time. 20 years ago. Jesus.
Maybe this movie didn't age well in some spots, but for the most part, this is such a solid movie, mainly because the performances by these two actresses that are powerhouse performances that really bring this movie up to iconic level. And I think, you know, it changed all of our lives. It made us the people we are today.
Truly.
Earthquake!
Grandpa, pass the milk!
Pass the milk! Thank you so, so much for joining me. I'll talk to you soon. Bye.
Want to give a huge thank you again to Danni Vitorino for joining me on this look back at Freaky Friday 2003. And I want to thank you for joining us today. Be sure to like and subscribe to Thembo Cinema for more reviews, reactions, and more nostalgic goodness. Be good to each other and always remember,
make good choices!